After creating our project, a design mode launches. In this mode, you create the user interface form structure using your own components, or with components provided by the Qt Design Studio. In design mode, Qt Design Studio renders the user interface as it would look without animations. On the left, you can see a bar called the mode bar. We can now see that the pencil icon is activated, telling us we are inside the design mode. The top button of the mode bar takes us back to the welcome screen that we saw in the previous video. The next button is the edit mode, which is the text editor. The text editor is a power user tool used for customizing the components or QML code. You can also find the debug mode, project settings, and the help menu in the mode bar. The help menu is useful for everybody. Usually, the designers do not need to touch the project settings, but the developers can change the settings and add more complex configurations there. The debug mode is also mainly for the developers. In the design mode, we can see that Design Studio has created a default screen for us, called Screen 1. Here, we will create and test our design in the next course.